Artists in a good trade, you jackass.
Good morning, Kick Nation. It's me, T-Bone. I'm in the HQ, and I am doing your favorite series, the top 10 worst trades of the week. Before we get started, look, guys, the video that I posted prior to this, the giveaway video with Carl Bull, please go in there. We're looking for a nickname for the subscribers. Remember, there's a $25 iTunes code on the line for you guys. So whoever I choose, whoever I pick, you guys will get a code. You got $25 to use on iTunes, and we'll have a new nickname for subscribers, so I don't have to call you subscribers anymore. All right, thank you, Carl Bull, for that suggestion. All right, let's go into the top 10 worst trades of the week.
Number 10.
Since at the end of the day, the purpose of these videos are to educate, Bob Norman, I want to educate you a little bit. 2.5 stars, this is a subtle bad trade. Not the worst trade in the world, but let me tell you why it's bad. Di Maria and Costa, let's say for the sake of argument, they're even. They're not. Costa's a little bit more valuable because you're going to get a little bit more points out of him because you get to use him a lot more week in and week out versus a UCL card. You take an 1,800 plus count Kamara card versus a purple Anya and a on-form Heller, not even close, man. Not even close to value as far as a collector, not even close to value as far as points, and a bad trade, and you're starting off this week's episode. Okay, Pun Measle, I don't know what your name is exactly, but you're at 172 trades. You have 2.5 stars, roughly, maybe 2.25, but you have to understand the concept, right? 20 card count versus 100 card count. And now, let's just compare names. Let's say they're even. Let's argue that. Sissoko for Ronaldo? Come on, dude. Look, you cannot be dumb. You probably sent this out to try to rip someone off. Because no one is that dumb. Really? No one. I don't think. Anyway, this is awful. Back of the net. You have an amazing name for Topps Kick, and you should do well with that name. However, not if you're going to send out bullshit trades like this. For a 2,500 count and a 3,000 count card, you want a 750 count on form. I get it, it's a UCL on form, but still, this is ridiculous. I don't get where you even think this is a fair trade. Right now, you're at 3 stars. You're going to have to step it up, homie, because despite the fact that you have an amazing name, this trade sucks balls.
Number 7.
I'd be lying if I didn't say I've done the voiceover for this like 3 or 4 times, Nielsen. I don't even know what to say to you. The other guys have hope. They have between, you know, 100, 200, 300 trades, at least some of them. But there is almost no hope for you. A best 11 for a mint. Really. 754 trades in, and you think this is a fair offer? Only send what you would be willing to accept, my friend. Come on, you got to get better than this, because honestly, if you send me a trade like this, I'm sending your ass straight to the trash pile.
Number 6.
Hey, Tom Hotspur. I think most Arsenal fans would agree that, you know, Hotspur's fans don't know what the fuck they're doing. I don't have that point of view. They do. With this, though, you're kind of validating that. Look, man, I don't know, what are those, 4 boots for a Lukaku Sig on form 300 count and the two ice scoring boosts? Are you kidding? Like, what's your issue with this trade? Like, seriously, like, are you that guy that the minute something comes out, it's so hot, it's got to be worth more than anything else? You have no ideas of values at all. And you have how many trades? Quite a few. It's an embarrassment, man. You got to learn from this.
Number 5.
All right, Jack Parksy 98, whatever your name is. Fuck it. Jackass. Look, jackass, this trade's fucking garbage. I don't even know what you're getting at. You have 913 trades, yet you think a Sig on-form Lukaku is worth 2 silver game changers, some award cards, a whole bunch of award cards, and a relic award. Man, what the fuck are you thinking? Seriously, if there's any kind of trade that burns my biscuits, it's this one. Nothing will take the jelly out of your donut faster than seeing a trade like this first thing in the morning. I tell you what I hate. I hate the fact that your name is Freebie because it seems like you're trying to get some shit that's free. Look, kid, there's nothing life and free. I'll tell you that right now. Second off, you know what? For us drinkers out there, this is one of those trades where we, you know, it's bound to happen, right? We accidentally accept that shit and then we got a war on our hands. Look, quit sending out some bullshit like this, bro, and learn.
Number 3.
I get trades like this all the time, and look, I've dealt with Hixie before. I've accepted trades from him, but more times than not, I decline. This wasn't sent to me. Obviously, it was sent to one of you, the subscribers, but Hixie, I gotta ask you something, man. Why do you devalue the gold game changer so much? That Laren gold game changer is amazing. It is an amazing game changer for a nice young player in the MLS. Look, MLS didn't dive that much to where it's only worth 2 fucking on forms, bro. You gotta respect that shit just a little bit. I'm not going to lie to you. I can't even read your fam name, so I'm just going to call you Ivana Humpalot because you're trying to bend someone the fuck over right now. Dude, honestly, I look at this trade, and I know you and I can never be friends, and I'm comfortable with that. You want all those on forms, VIP, a little bit of ice, ice, baby, a little bit of Yaya tour. You want all of that for a fucking record breaker? Are you kidding me? Like, seriously, what kind of Muppet are you?
You're number one of all the jackasses.
Yeah, I don't know what makes me more irritated, your name or this trade. It doesn't matter to me. Either way, I know you're a young player as far as 121 trades are concerned. You're at 3 stars, so hopefully this truly is a learning process for you. But I'm going to put it in perspective for you. That Ozil Gold Game Changer is arguably the best Gold Game Changer this year. It's not worth 48 of those damn inserts, much less 4. So, you know, how's that for a fucking assessment for you? Bottom line, you gotta learn to get better. These trades are awful, and, you know, use this as a learning tool. All right, guys, I really hope you enjoyed that episode. Look, you could put those trades in any order. It doesn't really matter, right? It truly doesn't. As long as we're learning from those, as long as some of the younger guys are learning from them, that's the ultimate goal with this series. Sure, it's a little fun banter thing and all that, and I try to make it as enjoyable as I possibly can with my, I don't know, dry sense of humor. Hey, look, Dream Crew, thank you very much. He's the one that donated the $25 iTunes code for that contest that we're having as far as naming subscribers. And hey, until next time, T-Bone out.
Don't piss in my pocket and tell me it's raining.